Welcome to the Huntsville United Methodist Church. If it's the first time you're here, we're glad you're here visiting with us. And if you need any more information about the church, we have an information center back there along the table, along the wall over there on the table, and back here as you come in this entrance. Or you can ask any of the ushers or greeters, Pastor Brian, myself, and we'll try and get you information you might need. We're going to touch on a few announcements in the bulletin real quick. The first one is the flowers on the altar are in honor of VBS and the children of our church and community. There will be an ad board meeting this week, and it's going to be tomorrow night at 6 p.m. So if you're involved in that, don't forget about that meeting tomorrow night. There's going to be a town hall meeting this Wednesday, 6 o'clock here at the church. So anybody that can attend has to deal with the future of the church. So it's very important. Anybody that can make it, please come and attend that meeting this Wednesday evening at 6 p.m. The mission team, that team is going to be leaving here on June the 24th, and we're going to be praying over those people at that time. So please try and attend that day as well and pray over those people that are going to be leaving the church and going down to serve God on that mission trip. There's some other things in bulletin. I'm not going to go over those. You'll give you a chance to look at those whenever you have a chance to. You don't have anything? I was going to say, I'm not going to skip Alice and the music today. Before we do that, if everybody would just get up and turn around and shake your neighbor's hand and say hi and welcome and good morning and just a minute and say hi to all your neighbors there. Thank you. I think that's a great way to start the morning. So, do I have any other announcements out there? If not, I'll turn it over to the praise team for worship.
All right. What a wonderful day to praise the Lord. Let's all stand as we begin our service. Because it's amazing grace. Let's stand as we sing.
I'll sing in joy.
you join me in a time of prayer as the ushers come forward? Looks like we have some special music for the offertory. Dear Lord, we need to thank you for giving this day to us, to allow us to come here to worship you freely without fear of persecution. And I'm reminded as I drive around each day and I see the crops starting to grow in the fields, we are much like those crops. We start out young and our faith journey starts, and as time goes by, we grow and grow. Please be with us as we grow in our spiritual journey leading to life in heaven, because your Son died for us on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins. As we offer these tithes to you freely, please bless them, multiply them to further your work here on earth. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Well, good morning. Great to see everybody here today. And Miss Mara, wonderful job on the piano. You have done an incredible job. You always do when you come up here and play this special. So thank you so much, especially on this Sunday when we have the kids in the house ready to celebrate vacation Bible school. I was at annual conference all week. I got back in time to get over here Friday morning to just get a glimpse of what was going on. And it was a madhouse. So Ashley, I'm glad to see your head is still attached to your shoulders. And to the staff that was surrounding her and working for these kids, you did a great job. I know you're going to do this, but I personally want to say thank you to you. And I want to say thank you to your team for everything that took place this week. And thank you to God for blessing us in such a way. So would you show your appreciation to Ashley and the volunteers? I want to take care of just a couple things before we go into a time of prayer. Number one, you may or may not know, we have a prayer request at each entrance of the church. You come in, you can fill them out. If you write down a name, you know, we're going to lift that person up during this time of prayer by name, whoever gets listed. So I want to say thank you for those who have filled those out and put the names down. A couple other things that I want to just address to you, since I got the floor and I have just a little bit of time. Number one, Phil alluded to our town hall meeting we have coming up this Wednesday. We're going to be talking about the General Conference 2019 meeting that's coming up. That is going to take a look at the United Methodist Church across the globe and make some decisions about who we are and the direction we are going forward. I want to let you know I've been working very hard. I've been doing a lot of study, went to some meetings, and you know what? We're going to talk about this on Wednesday, so if you're in any way interested about it, by all means, come be a part of this. I'm going to be there for a couple hours, and I will field as many questions as we need. I'm going to let you know what all the information I have so we can make a well-informed decision going forward about the future of the denomination. So I wanted to get that one out of the way. And just a couple other things. First of all, Sarah, I see you out there. I'm so sorry. As many of you know, a young gal by the name of Abigail Daig was killed in an automobile accident, and that would be Sarah's niece. And Sarah, for the pain that comes with this, I'm so sorry to you and to your family, to your brother, who's the father of your niece. I'm so sorry. You know, here at Huntsville, we want to be a church that surrounds those who are hurt, those who desire God's presence in their life. And Sarah, I want you to know we love you. We love your family. Anything we can do, we're there for you guys, okay? So just know you have our prayers, and just want to extend those condolences on behalf of an entire congregation, okay? Then also, along those same lines, our neighbor directly north of us, Bill and Diane Hurley, Diane passed away Friday afternoon, and I'm going to be officiating her services on Tuesday down at iColds. But if you could just keep the family in our prayers. We have a great relationship with our neighbors. It's good for a church to love your neighbor. So, and we've tried to practice that with the Hurleys, but you know, they've been a stalwart of the community. So I want us to keep that family in our prayers as well. And then I have just two other things before we go into a time of prayer. But the first one is just, this one came to me, and I hope this is okay. And you know, I probably should have asked permission, but this is so neat and so cool. But we have a couple in the congregation today that are celebrating 55 years of marriage, and they got married in this church, not in this church, but in that church right over there. We have Richard and Dixie Wallace in our congregation today. Guys, if you just raise your hand, 55 years, welcome back. So if any of our old-timers in the church or community members know the Wallaces, and we have some Wallaces here, I know Sib, you're sitting right, and I pointed them out. I said, well, Sib sits right over there. She's the Wallace. And there's a few others. By all means, go connect after church. They live in Marion now. But thank you for, after 55 years, you thought enough to come back here. And I always take a lot of joy in saying, well, we tweaked the building a little bit over 55 years ago, so... Thank you. And that's really what this is about. That's why we do what we do. We want people to be able to move closer to God through a committed relationship with Jesus Christ. And if we can't do that, then we're not going to do it at all. That is what we live and breathe for here at Huntsville. We love the Lord Jesus Christ, and we want to lift his cross up and draw all people unto him. So having shared that, there is now one more thing. And is it okay if I just take a personal moment here for the congregation? And I know there's a lot of people here today, but this is coming from a very personal place on behalf of Alice and myself, and I might as well include Hannah on that as well. You know, many of you probably saw on Facebook this week a missing report came out for our middle daughter, Josie. For those of you who did reach out to us in love and prayer on behalf of my family, I want to say thank you. Huntsville, your grace is abounding, and it is a beautiful, beautiful thing. Now, for those of you who are not familiar with our situation with our middle daughter, Josie, she came into our care when she was about 2 years old, and we eventually adopted her. Now, as I speak in a situation like this, and mind you, when you're the pastor of a church and you've been in the community for as long as we have, you know, there's a lot of visibility, and you don't always get the privacy and those kind of things. And I get that. I understand that. But I still want to try and protect her with the comments I'm about ready to make. I would carefully confide in you that from day one, she wrestled with mental health issues. Did I say that okay? Okay. As she continued to grow older through her pubescent and teenage years, those issues only intensified to a level that neither Alice nor I really care to talk about. It's very deep and very personal. Now, one of the great things about Facebook and social media is you can keep in touch with people and you can disseminate news and information. But one of the bad things about Facebook and social media is that people get to say things unfiltered behind a telephone screen or a computer screen. And a few of the comments questioned why we would wait to file this report if she's been missing longer. Like, well, she's been gone for over a year. Why didn't you guys do anything earlier? Well, the reality is, Alice and I have been working with the authorities for a long, long time on this. And there were reasons why it was finally released on Facebook and social media. And we understand that the general population won't know or have the information that we do, and for good reason, I might add. But please know that we have been working on this for a long, long time, longer than what others would know or be aware of. So at the end of the day, we would just ask for your continued prayers, for your thoughts. And in the meantime, if I could just humbly ask this of you, it is a private matter that Alice and I, we want to keep private amongst us and our family. So I just ask you, you kind of respect that as we move forward. Again, did I say that and go, did I do okay on that? No. Well, thank you. Thank you. But you know, church, you guys have been great. Like I said, we've been doing this for a long time now, and your love and grace abounds, and I thought I could say that and it would be all right, and you have affirmed me. So thank you. All right, so we are about ready to go into a time of prayer. So let's bow our heads. Let's do that. Well, Father in heaven, we just want to give you praise for this day that you have made, because it came from your gracious hand, and Lord, you have delivered it squarely unto us right here and right now. And so, God, for the blessings that we partake in, from just being able to rise, just to be able to put our feet from the bed down onto the floor this morning, God, it is incredible. To being able to stand up and then draw the breath of life, God. You know, to finding ourselves here at this church this morning on the Sabbath. And even in these moments to take time to rejoice with the saints of heaven who've gone on before us. God, for having this moment to laugh and to cry and to experience the whole gamut of emotions that life draws out of us. Well, this we know, God. This we know. If we're going to make it through this life, until we find ourselves on your shores in heaven, well, God, we need you. We have to walk with you. We got to want you. And Lord, when we walk with you, when we commit ourselves to you, you know what we discover? You are all that we really need, and you are enough, God. So thank you for being our God, for never leaving us, for never forsaking us. All praise goes to you in the name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. For it's in his name that, God, we lift up the prayers of our people today. And this morning, Lord, we pray for Anita and Rhonda, for the Clark family, as well as for Bob, Loretta, and Daryl, for Mary, Shirley, Larry, and Betty. We give to you Donna and Eva and the Stewart family. We pray for Brianna, Tyler, Scott, and Mike. Norm, Amy, Debbie. We give to you Mark, Michael, Charles, Michael, Heidi, and Donna. We lift up Katie and Kylie, Randy and Mr. Wynn. We pray for Sean, Matt, Kristen, and Hank, as well as Tina, Tanner, and Tom. For Larry and Dorothy, Glenn and Sandy. We give to you Joyce, Joe, Emma, Brittany, and Dustin, as well as Billy, Andy, Sue Ann, and Mary. We give to you Tom and Vicky, and we pray for Vicky, Amanda, and her family. We pray for Norma, Cheryl, Dorothy, and Billy. We give to you Vicky, Helen, Randy, and the Libertus family, as well as Shelley, the Shelley McGuire family, the Steele family, Skeeter, the Pope family, and we pray for Faith and Shannon, for the Dagg family, for Mara, Dustin, Stacy and Stephen McLaughlin. And God, we thank you for 55 years of marriage for Richard and Dixie. And Lord, we pray for the Hurley family, our neighbors. And God, for all the prayers to get brought to this time and place. For those that we've lifted up. For those that we hold in our heart, God. We thank you that you hear them. We just surrender them now to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who taught us all to pray aloud and together in one common voice. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen indeed. All right, so I know a lot of you are here today because we are celebrating VBS. As Ashley comes on down, as Jenna comes on down, I just want to take a moment to once again say thank you for the work and effort that Ashley, you and your team put on. And I want you to know, I am so excited and proud and humbled and honored to be part of a church that does stuff like this. So, Ashley, thank you. You have worked your tail off. I'm going to put a motion on the floor that when this is over, Ashley get about six weeks of just some downtime, and then her volunteers can just get some rest and recuperation, and we would pray them up in our spiritual life and pray for God just to surround them. If you would agree with me, would you give me an amen?
Yeah.
Amen. Ashley, it's all yours.
Oh, you guys are kind, but I'm so excited for this morning. I appreciate your kind words, but you and I both know only God can do something like this, right? So let's worship Him. Let's praise Him today. Not all of our friends are going to be here with us this morning. Just so you have an idea, there were 138 kids that ran through this church this week and 46 volunteer army mates that made it happen. phone had its coffee. It's ready to go. All right, guys, you guys want to do me a favor? Can you help me out? Can you spread out just a little bit so our friends over here can see you? Spread out like peanut butter and jelly. Oh, you guys are the bomb. All right, guys, so they want to hear your memory verse. They want to hear what God shared with you this week from his scriptures, okay? So I'm going to help you one time through, and then you guys are going to do it by yourself, okay? Are you ready for this? Here we go. We're going to start with his. Who's his? God. All right, so here we go, okay? 2 Peter 1:3. Here we go, as loud as you can. His divine power has given us everything required for life and godliness
through the knowledge of him who called us by his own glory.
All right, I don't think they heard you the first time, so I need you guys this time to do it even louder, all right? Let's let all of Huntsville know of God's goodness and that he is on the move and that he has given us everything required for life, all right? So as loud as you can, here we go by yourself.
Glory.
kids acting up here. Can somebody get this Sloan kid under control up here? His parents, goodness gracious. All right, hey, so we have some students that want to share some awesome things that God did this week. So if you are one of those students that are sharing this morning, can you guys come make a line for me right here? And teachers, guardians, I'm going to ask you guys to come up too. If you are sharing a praise this morning, if you guys, we're just going to pass the microphone and we're going to share some awesome things that God did this week, all right? So come on up, guys, don't be shy. Come on up. Awesome. Dawson, you're sharing for your class, aren't you? Okay, I'm going to let Dawson start us off, and then we're going to pass the microphone down, all right? So give him some grace, guys. This is nerve-wracking to get up in front, but we're going to make sure that we praise God and share with God this morning, okay? There you go, Dawson.
This past week at VBS was great. Most of the kids at the beginning had never seen each other before. Through the week, though, they made friends from different schools through the activities we've done. For example, we did crafts, missionary, and rec games, and teaching about God, but above all, praying and worshiping. And through all of these activities, we've come closer together as friends and as a church. Now I have two of my friends here from my group, all my friends here from my group, to share about their experience at VBS this week.
Jesus loves us all. I learned that a shepherd had 100 sheep and he lost one of them. So then he cared about all of them and he went and found that one.
I learned this week that Jesus rose Lazarus from his tomb.
I learned at VBS God sent his one and only son Jesus and I'm on team Jesus.
I learned that Doubting Thomas didn't believe that Jesus was actually alive from risen, so he had to see the hole in his hands.
I learned that two missionaries went to tell Jesus about Jesus, and they went to prison for telling about Jesus, and there was an earthquake that let all of the prisoners out. But those two stayed and told about Jesus, and the prison keeper thought he was going to be in trouble, but he brought those two people that were in prison and brought them home so they could be baptized.
It was an awesome week at VBS.
Jesus loves me.
I learned that Jesus and God loves us.
All right, guys, great work. Good job. Good job. Do we have any volunteers or teachers that want to share this morning? They're all shaking their head. They are tired. I tried to get them to go for round two, and they vetoed that. They need a year off. All right. Okay, cool. All right, guys, so we have one more skit. I'm going to pass the microphone back to them. So you guys get to see one more skit, and then no more skits till next year, all right? So stay tuned.
Hey, teammates. I can't believe our time together is almost over. It's been so much fun being on your team this week. We have had a great week of sports, but more importantly, learning about Jesus. That's great. Tell us the best thing you learned.
I learned that Jesus knows everything about us and loves us anyway.
Amazing. How about you guys? What have you learned this week? Tell two new friends one thing you've learned. Feeling better. I'm totally ready to get out there and play. It's not fun sitting on the sidelines. I know, and I still have my lucky hat. I haven't lost it again. Ah, what great memories. You know, I think we should do this again sometime.
Me too.
Deal. Let's meet right here at the same spot next summer, and we'll do a brand new adventure together. And sound like a plan? Great. Great job, everybody. That was fun. See you then. Here we come. Let's see what God did. $982.
are going to be going to Burkina Faso for kiddos your age to ride to school. That's so awesome that you guys did that. I want you guys to remember that God is always on the move, and when we have willing hearts and we give in big ways, God can do incredible things, all right? So great job to you guys. And then I need your help, and I need the congregation's help. If you were a volunteer, or like Carla has pointed out, if you were an army mate this week for VBS, can you stand up for me? Can you stand up for me? Don't be shy if you were here helping. Don't be shy. Stand on up. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Thank you so much. All right, real quick, I need to you guys to help me do a favor, all right? We're going to say thank you on the count of three. Volunteers, you know how much I love you. I'm so grateful for all that you gave this week. The sweat equity, the willingness to help with whatever it was. I just want to say thank you. And I want to remind us all, man, when we come together in the name of Jesus Christ, big things happen, all right? So let's keep up the steam. Let's keep giving. Let's keep rising together as an army and see what God has in store for us. I am so grateful for you. God bless you. I love you. I love you so, so much. We're going to say thank you on the count of three. Are you guys ready? As loud as we can. One, two, three. Thank you. Thank you. You guys are awesome. This is hilarious. So awesome. All for Jesus, man. I love it. I'm going to let it go. I think it's great. All right? Okay, guys, so let's worship as loud as we possibly can. Let's hear your joy as loud as you can. Let's do it for Jesus. So you guys can start to pray for next year's VBS and get ready. Does that sound good? All right, let me see all of your eyes. Let me see all of your eyes. I'm so proud of you. I love you guys so much, and I don't ever want you to forget how much you are loved by your Father God. And I want you to remember that God loved you so, so much that he sent his one and only Son, Jesus, to die on the cross for who? For all of us, all right? So nothing you do, nothing ever, ever, ever you do can separate you from the love of Christ, all right? You are his child. He has great plans for all of you. Even my three favorite monkeys that were dive bombing off the stage, they're going to be dive bombing for the rest of their life for Jesus. I know it, all right? So you guys, I know you're going to go out the rest of the summer and the rest of your lives, and I want you to tell people about Jesus. I want you to tell them about the stories of Lazarus and Thomas, and I want you to carry the love and grace of Jesus Christ with you wherever you go, all right? And I want you to love your brothers and sisters and your neighbors and your friends in the name of Jesus, and I want you to love them hard, okay? Because God loves you that much, all right? Are you guys ready to pray? All right, I have a baseball with me. And I know a lot of you play ball, okay? And normally at the end of the game, they have a game ball that they give to the most valuable player, right? Have any of you ever experienced that? In our lives, not only just VBS, but in our lives, the most valuable player is Jesus Christ, all right? None of this would be possible without Jesus Christ, all right? And I want him to be the MVP of your life, all right? I want you to know that you can trust him always. He's always a friend of yours. You can always talk to him. You can always pray to him. He's right there with you everywhere you go, all right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to place this game ball on the altar and give it to Jesus Christ. Are you guys with me? All right, let's do it. Here we go. All right, thank you, Jesus. Game ball, all for you. All right, let's bow our heads, guys. Bow your heads with me. Let's pray. God, you are so, so good. I just don't even have words, God, to describe how good you are, Lord. I thank you for just your incredible Holy Spirit that has filled this church and the army of volunteers, God, for the last 5 days and this morning, God. I give you praise for that. And God, as these kids are before me, Lord, and even our kiddos and friends that went through this week, God, that aren't with us this morning, God, whether they're at other churches or away, God, we pray for them too, God. I lift these precious children of yours up to you, God, and ask for more of you in their lives, God. I ask that they always remember that they are loved by you, that you have an incredible plan for their lives, God. And I pray also, God, that they are just filled with your Holy Spirit and they can go out and they can love other people, God, that they can love in grace and in service, God, all for you, Lord. God, we place that game ball right on the altar and we just say thanks for everything that you did, God. From the fun games, God, to missions, God, to raising almost $1,000 in coins, God, for kiddos in Burkina Faso, Lord. We just thank you for all of it, God. And Lord, we prepare already for next year, God. Lord, we want our vision to be your vision, God. So we throw our plans to the side. And God, as scary as this is, Lord, we say whatever you have planned for next year and for however many kiddos you have planned for next year, we open our hearts and our minds and our doors, God, and we just say, your will be done, God. We pray for next year already, Lord. And God, as they go today, I pray that they can go home and celebrate VBS, that they can talk about you with their family, that they can celebrate Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, and that your love and your light goes with them as they walk out the door, God. We give you praise for VBS. VBS 2018, God. We pray for VBS 2019, God. We just say thank you so much, God. We love you. And together we said, amen. Amen. All right, give me 2 seconds. Give me a drum roll, a big one, because I'm kind of slow. A big one. I need a bigger one, and a bigger one, and a bigger one. here, and I can't wait. All right, we need to do one more God's team, and then I'm going to turn it back over to Miss Alice and her worship team, all right? Come on in, guys. Come on in. Bring it in. Bring it in. Bring it in. Bring it in. Come on in, Trace.
Hey, thank you again. Great presentation, kids. I enjoyed the show. So if you would join with me and just sincerely one more time saying thank you to Ashley, to the kids, to the volunteers, to everybody that made this possible. Thank you, all right? And as the band gets in place, ready to go for our closing song, just a couple things that I want to do. Number one, for the next 2 weeks, we've got some really cool things happening here on Sundays as well. Next week, we have a Father's Day panel. We're going to be hearing from some men and from fathers and how God has helped them get through some really difficult times in their lives and how they've continued to press on to be a role model of Jesus Christ in their family's life and in their kids' life. So I want to invite all of you to come back and be a part of that. We did a little something like that for Mother's Day, and it was very powerful. So we want to invite all of you back to be a part of this for Father's Day. And in the following week, we have our mission team. Where's Jerry at over on the drums? Jerry and his crew are going to be getting ready to head down to Kentucky. And we're going to bless them. We call it a mantling service. And so we're going to be praying for them. We're going to be lifting them up. It's going to be a great service because when they leave on that Sunday from here, they walk out the doors into their vehicles and they're heading down to Appalachia, Kentucky to be in service for the week. So as a church, I want us to surround them and bless them and love them in that way. And finally, the last thing. As you looked up here today and you saw all these kids, and you think about when we ask the question, well, what kind of church do we want to be in this community and for God's purposes in this life? Well, I think this begins to capture it today when you see all those kids. But understand, to the volunteers that made this possible, thank you. Because if this is what you want, it takes volunteers like that. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you for what you've done and how you've done it this week. I know you're tired. I know you're exhausted. And you know what? God is going to bless you for that. That is a good way to go through life for the kingdom. So thank you to the volunteers. I love you. I so appreciate your work and your effort from the youngest to the oldest in that span right there. Thank you so much. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
All right, Alice, we'll turn it over to you.
Let's all stand as we close out our service with, Lord, I lift your name on high. Let's stand as we sing.
I'm not afraid.
if there's one thing the kids taught us today, it's that we are on a team. And God is not on our team, but the call is for us to go be on God's team. Amen?
Amen.
All of you are invited into God's great kingdom to be His witness, to be His teammate, to do this thing called life in His grace and in His love and in His care. So friends, go forth today as being part of God's team. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.